Hello everyone, Amy R here with Prairie Paper and Ink, and for today's Halloween card, I am using one of the brand new, just released sets from Honeybee Stamps. This is the Hey Pumpkin stamp set. So I'm participating in a blog hop today to kind of celebrate the new release, and of course I had to use this set because it's one, it's adorable, and two, Halloween themed. So you can use this for fall themed cards as well, but of course I went Halloween with it. So I'm using some Strathmore Ready Cut watercolor paper, and I have it lined up in my Misti, and then I lined up the stamp, and I made sure there was enough room where I placed the stamp because I want to use the coordinating die cut for it. And then I'm inking up the stamp as well as the little witch hat stamp that's separate. Like I said, you can use it to create a Halloween card, or you can just use the image as is so it's more fall themed. So I'm stamping those with some VersaFine Onyx Black ink, and I stamp those multiple times to get a perfect crisp black image. And then I'm taping this down to my cutting board here, and again, lining up the coordinating die, because you can see there's that large like rectangle area at the bottom of this die cut. So I wanted to make sure that my tape didn't cover any of that area. So what I actually found was easiest was I took my pencil and went around the whole perimeter of the die. That way I've got a bit of a visual guide to when I go to watercolor this to know how far out I want to take all the color, because I want the whole like area completely covered. So I made sure I'm not covering any of the areas with tape, and then I taped this down with some painter's tape, and then I'm going to use my Mission Gold watercolors to watercolor this in. So I've super sped this up because it took, I think, about half an hour to 45 minutes, roughly. I just kind of sat and zoned out and colored and just had fun with it. I love it. No other words. I just layered the colors and just kind of did my thing. So I'm just going to play some music right now, and then I will be back in a bit to explain how I did the rest of the card. Thank you. Alrighty, so once everything was completely dry, I'm going to remove the tape, and then I'm going to use remnants of that tape to hold both of these dies in place so that they don't shift when I run them through my Big Shot machine. So one thing I really love about this coordinating die set for this stamp set is it cuts out the perimeter of this large image as well as like the center areas between the trees. And then I do really like that it cuts out just kind of the rectangular bottom, which is going to come in handy in a minute. So I tape that into place, and then I'm going to tape the hat die into place as well, and then I'm going to run this through my Big Shot machine. So once I've run it through and everything is die cut, I used my scissors to trim that bottom area of the hat so that, it removed that white area, and two, I wanted it flush right up to the edge of the brim there so then it looks more seamless, so it kind of sits on her head better. So I'm going to trim off that area, and then I'm going to continue the cut right along that brim so it literally kind of slides right onto her head, and then the edges of the hat will kind of slide underneath. So did two little cuts like so, and then it just fit perfectly on her head, and that just made me happy. So this part was a little nerve-wracking. I wanted to stamp the sentiment directly on this watercolor piece, but it's like after you do all this, you know, watercolor, it's like I do not want to wreck this. So I used my anti-static powder tool, and then I poured the embossing pad over it just as is, making sure that it's not clinging to anything, that everything is 100% dry, and that worked. So I'm going to line this up into my Misty again, and I'm just using one of the creative corners to kind of hold it into place, and then my bigger magnet just to hold this down perfectly. Use my anti-static powder tool yet again, and then I'm inking up the Hey Pumpkin from that set with some Versamark ink. I ended up stamping it twice because, again, this is a little bit textured. This watercolor paper isn't really heavy textured, but again, I didn't want to be too careful because I wanted to make sure this was stamped and perfectly, and it was. So I poured my white embossing powder over it, made sure everything was good, and then I melted it with my heat tool. I let my heat tool heat up for a few seconds, make sure it was good and hot before I brought it to the watercolor paper, and then melted that with my heat tool, and then I was so happy that it worked. I did think one way to get away with it was to stamp it on vellum, and then I was going to layer the vellum over that, but I didn't want to cover any of the watercolor. Even though you'd still be able to see it through the vellum, it wouldn't have been, you know, as nice, I guess. So it worked. So now I can go into my card base. So I have some plum colored cardstock here, and I had cut it down to 4.25 by 8.5. And I scored it. So this is going to be a 4.25 inch square card. And then the card base itself, I taped down the back part of the card into my Misty. I wanted it moved up a little bit here in my Misty because I'm going to stamp a background to cover the entire card front. So I'm holding it in place with that because I can't use my magnets for this because the stamp is so big. This is the previously released Ocean Borders stamp. So it's this large background stamp, but it's a clear stamp. So I've got it lined up again in my Misty here. I've got the card base kind of taped down. I used my anti-static powder tool, and I inked up the stamp again with Versamark ink, and I can press that down, and I wanted to make sure this stamped perfectly on this entire card front, which it did. And then I thought about leaving it as is, but I wanted to make it even more like obvious, this background, because it's gorgeous, and I thought it would be perfect with like this Halloween theme and the colors I chose. So I'm coating it with some Nouveau Clear embossing powder. So pouring that over the entire card front here, and then same thing, got my heat tool good and hot, and then melted all of this embossing powder, so this gorgeous like swirled background. So even though it's the Ocean Border stamp set, I think it makes a fun, like, kind of makes you think of like almost a swirly cloudy sky in a way. So while I have my card base out, I'm going to finish the inside of the card. So I use the anti-static powder tool again, and then I'm using the Happy and the Halloween stamps from the Hey Pumpkin set. Line those up with the Misty, and then I'm going to stamp those and emboss them in white. Melt that with my heat tool. And then while I was doing all this, like in the back of my mind, I was thinking about stamping that main image again on the inside of the card just to finish it off. But I still wanted her to be wearing her hat. So in order to pull this off and make it look seamless, I kind of lined up the main stamp where it was going to go. And then before doing anything with the main stamp, I inked up the hat with the Versamark ink, stamped that onto the inside of the card. And then I had stamped and cut out a mask for just the hat here. So I'm going to mask off that top portion of the hat. Now I can line up that stamp directly over where it's going to stamp, making sure, you know, her head lines up with the hat. And then close the lid of the Misty, ink that up with the Versamark ink, press that down onto the inside of my card, remove the mask, and she's wearing her hat. So I was quite proud of myself that this worked. And once the Versamark ink is dry, you can write over this with a ballpoint pen. I would use a jelly, like a gel pen anyway, because this is kind of darker cardstock, but you can write over it, no problem. So that finished off the inside. And then, so I popped up this main watercolor image onto my card front with some foam tape. So it's popped up with a little bit of dimension. And then I used a whole bunch of sequins from three of the different new packs from Honeybee. And that's actually what kind of inspired the colors of this card and everything. So that's why I used them. And I couldn't resist. I wanted to like coat this entire thing with sequins. I went overboard with the sequins because I couldn't help myself. But I have the Fall Equinox, the Indian Summer, and the Enchanted Plum mixes. And sprinkled them rather liberally on my card and adhered them into place with some multimedia matte adhesive and used my crystal katana to pick up the sequins and press them into place. And then as a final bit of embellishment, I used my Stardust Jelly Roll pen just to add a little bit of shimmer to the buckle of her hat and her little buttons on her shirt. And then I just added a few little dots to the pumpkin and to her hair. Just subtle, but it gives that little bit of sparkle without, you know, covering up the watercolor going too overboard. So that finished off my card for today. So like I said, I'm participating in a blog hop with a bunch of other fabulous designers to kind of celebrate this release. I will have info about that in my blog post. There's also giveaway info, all that kind of fun stuff going on. So definitely check out the description box below the video and my blog. Thank you guys so much for watching and subscribing and thumbs upping my videos. And I will see you all very soon in the next one. Bye.